Tom Brady and NFL Players Association have filed for a second hearing with the U.S. Federal Appeals Court, hoping that the entire 13-judge panel will be willing to hear the case. At this point, we have two judges who have ruled in favor of Tom Brady. We have two judges who have ruled against Tom Brady. So the situation calls for clearly a tiebreaker, but will the Second Circuit Court be willing to hear that case remains to be seen. If the Federal Appeals Court rejects this motion, then Tom Brady's only recourse will be to attempt to take it to the U.S. Supreme Court. However, it is unlikely that the Supreme Court would be willing to listen to this case, but in the case of Deflategate, we have had many surprises already. Tom Brady's argument is that this was at most an equipment violation. However, the NFL Commissioner Roger Goodell feel that it was conduct detrimental to the game, which falls under the personal conduct policy, which allows Commissioner Goodell to issue a suspension that he feels is just. The NFLPA feels that this four-game suspension is excessive in this matter, and that's why they are willing to take this as far as they can. The big issue here is the NFLPA wants to take disciplinary power away from Commissioner Roger Goodell and give it to a third-party independent arbiter. They won in similar instances with Ray Rice. They won in a situation with Adrian Peterson. The Players Association is willing to take this on behalf of Tom Brady as far as they can, whether they have to go to the U.S. Supreme Court if the Supreme Court is willing to hear it. They have hired Olson, who is an attorney who has had success in the Supreme Court, and that shows that they are bringing in all the firepower they can to get Tom Brady vindicated.